On Monday, February 11th, there will be a special town meeting at Hopkinton Middle School. The meeting will start at 7 p.m. At this past Board of Selectmen meeting, they went through the articles.
Back in 2017, Article 19, the town meeting voted approximately, I believe, $140,000.
Article 2 was unanimously approved by selectmen and regards an increase in the amount to repair the Lake Maspinock Dam.
That number, the original number, assumed that the town was going to be able to lower the dam level to a manageable level. I think in my discussions with John, what then happened was, as the project review progressed, it became clear that lowering the dam level substantially would impact the surrounding wells. And therefore, work now has to be conducted with much more water in the dam than was originally planned. And the request now is for an additional funds that will bring the project total to $250,000 for the repairs to be conducted.
All right. It was $110,000, and now they're asking $140,000. Okay, total.
An additional $140,000.
Additional $140,000 for a total of $250,000.
Article 3 was also unanimously approved by selectmen and authorizes funds towards a fire communication system project.
This project is almost the first of its kind relative to Verizon's request that towns discontinue the use of copper wires. And I recall vividly that when the chief came before the Board of Selectmen, the Appropriations Committee, CIC, that he did explain back in 2018 that for the most part we will be designing this project as we build. And that is the reason why the amount of the project has gone up by $57,750, and we're requesting town meeting vote to approve this appropriation so that we can complete this project. It is related to public safety. And again, the explanation is that this is the first of its kind and we're designing as we build.
Article 4 was unanimously approved and is a tax increment financing agreement between the town and Lycan Biosciences, LLC. The article was approved at the January 29th meeting. Initial discussion took place January 17th.
Science. Lycan Bioscience is an emerging manufacturer of cell and gene therapies, very new generation of therapeutics. So new that there's only four approved currently, but gaining a lot of traction, and it's the next generation of therapeutics over and above beyond what we've seen before from biologics. Company plans to lead the way in manufacturing clinical products out of the Hopkinton site for immunotherapies of cancer and other illnesses. I will say that our sole focus right now is oncology. That's where the greatest need is. That's where we see the greatest need. So that's where we'll focus. Immunotherapy is on a cutting edge of treatments that are less invasive than traditional cancer therapies, and they offer a promise of greater patient safety. This is personalized medicine for the most part, so we're using patient cells, patient's blood, treat the blood at what would be the Hopkinton site, send back the patient very quickly with very little inventory or zero inventory, and then reinfuse the reinjected back into the patient, lights the patient's own immune system up to whatever cancer they're fighting, breast, colon, lung, whatever the case may be.
Also at the selectmen meeting, the Hopkinton Police Department introduced the newest canine member, Titan.
Once it was determined that we could bring back a canine, obviously we were very excited. I don't know how many of you ever remember the late Hank Fredette and Lucky,
yes.
But that was my junior years here, and it was an amazing time to have it. So when we were able to get one to come back, the late Frank Stanton Fund funded us for this. They gave us a grant for $25,000 that we can use over the next 3 years to fund everything from training to outfitting his cruiser to equipment for him, veterinary bills, building a home for him at Officer Secchione's house and so forth. It's been great for us. All we have to do is submit our quarterly reports on it and continue with the training. Most of the training I'll let Brian talk to you about, but it's been a great asset for our department, and I'm very excited at the station.
And before I ask Brian, I think when I spoke with you ahead, Jay, you explained to me that the town and Titan has been gifted a protective vest. Those run about $900.
Yeah, so the grant allowed for us to purchase a vest, but through a generous donator had seen Titan on I believe it was a Facebook page, fell in love with him, a gentleman out of Boston, and asked if he could donate the $900 to buy Titan the vest, and it was accepted by the town, and Titan now has his own ballistic vest. We've been very fortunate with the outpouring from the community. We've had another generous donation of Narcan for him in case he ever gets exposed to narcotics in his line of duty. Brian now has a Narcan kit to assist him.
Excellent.
And the donations keep coming in. It's been great outpouring from the community.